Fine. So when we will talk about the BI, BI means the business intelligence and DI means the data integration. Okay. So first we will see the requirement of this tool, why we need this tool. So business intelligence is the art of gaining a business advantage from data by answering the fundamental question such as how various customer rank or business doing now or how is this. So what happened? My customer is coming with the huge data, but to see the data they cannot take the decision because that data is just a data, not an information. So what we need to do, based on the data we have to create some reports, graphs, and we have to analyze our data. So once we will analyze our data, whatever the end product we are sending to client, that will be either report or graph, that will helpful for my client to taking the decision. Okay. So for decision making purpose, we are looking for the such type of tools. Okay. Because my client have a lot of questions and based on the assumption they cannot take any decision. So for taking the decision, they need some fact and figures. So fact and figures will come from the data, whatever data client send me, and based on that data we will perform the task. So here basic flow of the data is I'm getting the raw data. Raw data means the notepad file, XML file, Excel file, whatever data is coming from the client. That data we are inserting in the DI. So first we will work on the DI. DI is the ETL tool. So here we will work on different transformations and all, and after that we will create the data mart. The data mart is using for the other BI tool, business intelligence tool, as an input. So that data mart created by DI Studio and used by the other BI software. So after using that data, we will create some meaningful information, means some report, graph, dashboard, something like that, and meaningful information we can create it all. So that information we will send to our management or the client. So my client will take some action out of that all information. And once they will take the action, that action make them more profit in the business, increase the revenue, reduce the cost, stability and all. So for that, they want all the analysis. Okay, for example, I have one data mart or the Walmart, okay, Walmart, Big Bazaar, such type of departmental store we do have. So what I want to do, I want to increase my sales. How to increase the sales? So first we have to see what is our pain area, where my sales is less, where we can work so we can increase the sales. So what we will do, we just take all the data, daily days, transactional data. We will analyze all the data, which day, how much sales we have. So we can see Sunday, Saturday, Sunday highest sales is there. Monday, Tuesday also good sales are there. Friday also good sales. But Wednesday I have very less sales. Okay, because it's a mid of the week, so very less people are coming. So to see this you know, information, what my management will do, they will give some offers. If you will do you know, shopping on Wednesday, you will get 10% discount or 5% discount. So they attract the client based on their offers. But how they will arrive with the decision to take the offer? Based on the reports, whatever they are generating. So all the big businesses, they are collecting their data, they are analyzing the data. Out of the analysis and all, they will create this report and graph, and that report and graph helpful for decision making. So management people will sit, they will build some strategies and all. So all the base of each and every decision is the reports which come out of the data. Okay, so here analyzing the data is very important for taking the decision and enhance the business, which is our client requirement. So when we are working on the, can you mute your mic if you have question, and mute and you can ask. Okay. Sorry. So when we will talk about the business intelligence, we have some stages. First stage, we have to aggregate our data. For the aggregation purpose, we will use the ETL tools like SASDI. So here we will aggregate the data, make all the data in the standard format. If my information is available in multiple file, we will merge all the file using SQL joins and all. And if I want to create a new column or calculate something, which we, if I want to sort the data or if I want to give some condition, all the, you know, manipulation related stuff we will complete in the DI Studio, and we will create the data mart. That data mart is useful for reporting purpose. So we have Enterprise Guide, OLAP Cube, Information Map Studio, different tools are there. We can use that information and create the report and graphs. That reports and graph goes to a statistician. They will you know, read that all information and come up with some decision. I mean, come up with some more analysis, and that last analysis or the, you know, actual picture of the business will go to management or the client. Based on that all information, it will they will take the decision. Okay, so that is the flow of the data into BI and DI. So when we are working in BI and DI, all the BI and DI tool is associated with the central metadata repository. Central metadata repository is the repository is the term which we are using where we are storing the data. Okay, so my central metadata repository will join with all the tools like SAS Management Console, all the tools. So if I will work on one tool and save the data, we can retrieve that data by the other tools. Okay, so here we have Management Console. Management Console is the tool that will take care of the admin part. Now after that, we will come to DI Studio. DI Studio is the software which is helping for ETL purpose, extract, transfer and load. Okay, after that we will get the data mart. That data mart we can use for Information Map Studio, Enterprise Guide, Web Report Studio, Information Delivery Portal, OLAP Cube Studio, anywhere, wherever I want. Now based on the requirement of the client, we will choose the tools like Enterprise Guide. Enterprise Guide is the tool where we can do everything. How we are doing in the SAS 9.2, we can do by the Enterprise Guide. Extracting the ETL also we can do, creating the report, everything we can do it. Okay. Later on, we will come to the other tools. So based on the client requirement, if they want to create the OLAP cubes, means multi-dimensional report, then we will come to OLAP cubes. If they want to see the consolidated report or user friendly, then Information Map Studio. Then that information map we will display on the Web Report Studio. Then if I want to keep whatever, suppose I'm sending the mail to one person, again and again sending the mail to everyone is tough. So what I will do, I will create my own platform and I will update the report there and give ID password to everyone. So whenever the people want, they will enter in that particular portal and they can see the information. So my manual job will reduce and everyone will be in the same page. So for that we have multiple tool which we are using in our BI and DI. So here for the preparation of the data, we are using the Information Map Studio, OLAP Cube Studio. For displaying the data, Web Report Studio, BI Dashboard, Information Delivery Portal, Add-in Microsoft. Now what is the Add-in Microsoft? In the Microsoft tool, like we have Excel tool, Access tool. If I open this all tool in the BI environment, suppose Excel file, I will open it. Okay, so here I will get the additional button called SAS. Using this button, I can you know, connect with the metadata repository. After that, whatever data is available in metadata repository, we can access the data using the Microsoft Office files like Excel, Access, PowerPoint, like that. So that is the add in Microsoft. Now helper tool. EG, it's complete in itself. With the EG, we don't want any tool. So though we have multiple tools, but we are not using all the tool in the you know, in the same organization. We will not use all the tool. We will use a combination of tool, either DI and EG, either DI and the OLAP cube or EG. Most of the time EG people are prefer. Then if the client have the fluctuated data, then dashboard. If the end user point of view we have to make anything, then information delivery portal, web report studio. Anyhow, we will use management console because it is the admin tool. So altogether, this all we are using, and this all tools are connect with each other. Whatever data is coming, that we will keep in the central metadata repository, and one by one, wherever I want to extract the data, we can extract the data. So as for the preparation of the data, we have different tool like OLAP Cube Studio, Information Map Studio, like that. So OLAP Cube Studio is the full form of OLAP, is the online analytical process. This is the technique where we can use the multidimensional analysis, and for that background process is MDX. MDX is the like SAS programming when we will use in EG, and we are dragging and dropping the files and all, and background SAS program is created of. But here when we are dragging and dropping, MDX coding is created of in the OLAP cubes. It is the separate server is there, and we have to install some software for that. So that is the OLAP cube. Here we have a lot of data, and this data will be in the summarized format, pre-summarized format. So accessing the data from OLAP is more faster. Now Information Map Studio. It is the building the information from the DBMS, any of the database, SAS data, OLAP Cube Studio. Information Map allow you to join the table, rename the variable, and set the data into business friendly view. So this Information Map Studio, Web Report Studio, Information Delivery Portal, these are more user friendly job, where other people who don't have much SAS coding idea, they can work on this also. Okay, now Web Report Studio, here we can work on the cubes, information maps, whatever we are creating in Information Map Studio, we can display here. And simply we are defining the interface for the end user, whatever column they want, they drag and drop and create their own report. Okay, now add in Microsoft. As I told you, we have multiple Microsoft facility like Excel, Access, PowerPoint, and everywhere we will get the additional button called SAS, and by that we can access the data from the repository. Now Enterprise Guide. Enterprise Guide is the full SAS 9.2 version in the drag and drop. By drag and drop we can perform whatever we want to do it. Here also we can access the data from any of the software. Now Prompt Framework. What is the prompt? We are asking input from the end user. Who is my end user? I'm asking the information. Suppose I have reason. I have 6 reasons data. Now my client want particular reason data. So every time my developer have to sit and give them the report, you know, based on the reason they have to send the report. But here we will give the facility. All the data is available. Just you input your value for the reason, based on that reason your data or the report will come. So it will be the more user friendly. So prompt is generating based on the inputs of the prompts my end reports will create it off. Now stored procedure, just like a macros, whatever macros we are creating, and whenever I want we can call the macros. So that is the stored procedure. Now dashboard. In your car, you can see we have the dashboard, no? How much petrol is there? It is in reserve or it is full, like that. Same way, sometime my data is there, which is more sensitive data. I want to see how the data is fluctuated. Rather than going to figures and all, it is easy for me to see in the indicators. So suppose my one project is going on, we have the deadlines and all, we will keep in the dashboard. So I want to see whether my project is on time or before the time, or it is still behind the time. Okay, so that all we can find out by the dashboards. Now, information delivery portal, it will create one portal kind of website. Whatever data you want to keep, you will keep there, and who are the user which have the authority, they can open the portal and they can see the data. Now, management console, as I told you, it is the administrative, adding the user, give the authorization to user, everything will be there in the management console. Now, if you are the developer, if you are the admin, so as you work on the management console, you know if admin related job will who are doing the admin related job, they will work in the management console. Who are the developer, they are work in SASDI, Enterprise Guide and OLAP Cube. For the report creation, the people are using Add-in Microsoft and Web Report Studio. For the data exploration, we are having the Enterprise Miner and the forecast server, which I will not take care. Information consumer, who is the end user, they will use the information delivery portal, web report viewer, Add-in Microsoft and web OLAP viewers. So that are the different tools using by the different work role in the organization. Any question now?
No, I am fine, and I understood what you have said.
Okay, so when I will give the training, I will give the training on the virtual machine. In the virtual machine, I have all the software, so I will take the care of the training. Here, I will take the training by the example. So I have the infile. Using the infile, we will create different jobs. In the job, we will perform the task. Okay, so I will let you know what are the transformations are there, how to use the transformation with the example. So I will use data transformation, output, everything. Only data quality I will not take care, data flex and all I will not take care. Apart from that, I will take care everything. Okay.
So how can I practice in this, because I'm not having this software 9.2?
So I will send you the VMware. So
okay.
You can install and you can do the practice. Okay, so same way I have all the software, EG, everything. So I will explain you everything but with the example, and there you can work on that. Okay, so one by one everything.
Okay.
Here also fetching the data, how to give the data flow, what is the process flow, like that I will explain everything, and how to fetch the data from the data mart, where is the repository, everything will be there. And management console also I will let you know how to create the repository, user repository, how to create a user, how to give the access to user for the particular repository and all, that will be the management console. Then we will come to OLAP Cube, how to define the data for hierarchies, different hierarchical way and all, that all will be there in the OLAP cubes. So everything I will cover in my training, whatever the software I explain, this all will be covered in my training.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Any other expectation?
Okay.
You do have?
No, I'm fine with the course curriculum, what you are going to cover. I'm fine with this, madam.
Okay. Fine. So if I mean, we will go through like this. We will start with the EG, we complete the EG, then we will come to DI Studio, then we will come to OLAP Cube, then information delivery port, information map studio, then web report studio, then information delivery portal dashboard, like that. One by one we will go to all the softwares.
Okay, ma'am. So when are we going to start the class, madam? If you are, I mean, I'm fine with the course curriculum, I want to go ahead with the course. So when shall we, where?
Okay.
When shall we start the regular classes?
What's your available time?
after, I mean, 8 p.m. is fine for me.
You are from which
or 7
place?
7 p.m. I am from Hyderabad only.
Hyderabad only. 7 p.m. Actually...
Or 8 p.m.
Okay.
I mean...